What do you think about my feelings? If I am from the date of 23 June to the moment I didn't see any of my six farms. I send workers to do what I put in moment that it must be done in these days. And this is not enough. I'm deprived from the permit. It's not for security as the Israelis claim. It's first of all, they want to neglect our lands. And the second thing for me personally, they want me to close my mouth. They don't want me to participate in international forums because in these forums, I meet a lot of Europeans, I meet a lot of media, and I explain the situation here. We have the unfair competition with the Israelis. We are not allowed to sell our products inside Israel, but the Israelis sell their products inside our cities. We are not allowed to send our products inside our cities. One day we dare to send a truck loaded with our vegetables and for salad. The driver has to pick down all the boxes. You took about an average of 6 tons. So the driver at least needs 2 hours to pick down all the boxes, and he has to wait the soldiers to check every box. And he has to reload the boxes again. So he will look all the day. And such a case, our products will be sold in the second day as not fresh vegetables. This means half price. And the income, most of the time is less than the cost which we needed to produce our products. They have a serious competition with China and with Japan. And they don't want Iraq and Iran petrol to be easier for the Chinese and for the Japanese to compete USA. I think that it's one of my duty. It's a main duty to me to talk on behalf of the farmers in Palestine. 1979, there's a famous Israeli professor named Arnold Sofer. He issued his first map. He's a professor in Haifa University. He issued his first map about the wall in 1979. And we call this man the godfather of the wall. Because at that time, there were no Hamas, no jihad, no suicide bombers. And according to his statistics, Palestinians will be 60% of the population in historic Palestine at 2020. So he believes that the wall will deprive at least 1 million Palestinians from their main sources, and they will have no choice but to immigrate. And he assumed that the Israeli government will replace this 1 million of Palestinians with 1 million of Jewish about the world, and there will be no demographic problem. This is the main idea of the wall. We want the Israelis through negotiations to deal us with mutual respect, to stop dealing us that they are the masters and we are the slaves, with equality and rights. This is what we needed. But we are completely convinced that there is no possibility for Palestinians and for Israelis to have two states in this very small country. We have to build one state, one democratic state. It's the only solution to end the problem of the Palestinian refugees. It's the only solution is to have our rights and our underground water, which Israel considers security for the Israelis. It's our water. But we don't say that they are deprived from this water, but it's the good solution that all of us can use it. We need the solution for the case of Jerusalem, because the Israelis want Jerusalem their capital and we want it our capital. I think the one solution, the one state, can be achieved if the majority of Israelis recognize our rights. If they recognize it, it's no problem to have one state. That's what we believe.